Curious about lighting an interview using only the natural light in the room? Well, wonder no more. In this video, I'll demonstrate how to ditch your artificial lights and effectively use diffusers and reflectors to achieve the perfect exposure. We recently filmed this interview inside of a home where the living room had a lot of windows with great natural light, so I wanted to use it as much as possible. The fireplace was nice, but we decided to point the camera towards the kitchen instead. It gave us a lot more depth without having to move the couch and rearranging the entire entertainment center. You can see the camera here, and we'll sit our subject on this stool in front of the sofa. This orientation now dictates that our main light source, our key light, will come from the right side of our subject. We want to use those windows to make the right side of his face brighter, not fight against them. We filmed in the morning, so the sun was still low and the light was not directly beaming through the windows, making it perfect for us to use. You can see that the bottom windows had shutters, and so we used them to control the amount of light coming into the right side of our subject. The top windows had no way of blocking the light, so they provided the majority of our key light. I only had a really small diffuser, so I set it up right above my subject, just off a frame, to soften the light hitting our subject's face. We didn't need to use any other bounce or reflector for our key light. There was plenty coming from the window. It was more than enough. On the other side, we use a silver reflector as a fill light. The reflector is not being hit by direct sunlight, so the reflection is actually really soft. We opened the shutter on this window to make sure that we had enough light coming in to achieve the right contrast. Looking at our EL zone system, we can identify our key to fill ratio at about 3:1. His skin tone is about one stop above middle gray, and the fill side is about half a stop below. All I needed to do to change the ratio was to bring the reflector closer to reduce the ratio, or further away to make the fill side darker. The white bounce board was just not enough, especially because the subject is centered in the frame. We can't bring the bounce board close enough without it being in the shot. So the silver reflector worked out great. We also used a small silver reflector to push some light onto his chin to remove harsh shadows. Originally, we turned off all those under cabinet lights, but when we turned them back on, we saw that they provided a very nice accent to our picture. The challenge was that their color temperature was very warm, so we needed to adjust our white balance from 56K to 46K to find the right balance between the daylight and those under cabinet lights. We now have a nice warm feel mixed with the blue hue of the daylight. We did use an actual light for the backlight that you can see right here. Now, I typically like a backlight to be pretty warm. I don't remember exactly what the color temperature of the backlight is set to, but maybe around 40 or 38K. The backlight is actually set a little bit off to the side. The truth is, I didn't have an arm long enough to keep the stand off a frame and have the light dead center, so it's slightly to the right of the frame. And so you can see that it creates a kind of a highlight line on the left side, on the back of his head, and on his left shoulder. And I actually like that, and when he moved around a little bit, that line would shift slightly to be either more on the side or more on top, depending on his head movement. And it just looked pretty nice. When we look at the log file on the scope, everything is exposed pretty well. This is S-Log 3, so middle gray should be set to 41, skin tone at about 50, and highlights just above 60. Then on the graded side of the waveform, I like to crush the blacks a little bit, and I added even more contrast. Our key to fill ratio is now more like 5:1. And then you can see that I still have some room on the highlights. We were able to expose this properly using the natural light coming in the room and using a very minimal setup. I hope this was helpful, but feel free to share your own setup or how you would have done things differently. Now, thank you for watching this video until the end. As a token of my appreciation, I'd like to offer you my free camera setting cheat sheet. Just follow the link below to download the free cheat sheet. Thanks again, and happy filming.